People have been interested in grouping behaviour for a long time. In the last sort of 10 years, 5 or 10 years, there's just been an explosion of interests.
My work is on collective animal behaviour. So what we see here are schools of fish and shortly you see flocks of birds. And what's fascinated me ever since I was a kid is how and why animals coordinate their behaviour in this way. And so we develop computer simulations, as shown here, where we can show, in actual fact, where people used to think this was driven by telepathy or thought transference, what we now know it's driven by relatively local interactions among the individuals.
It's actually this motion, this fluid-like nature of these groups that allows them to so effectively make decisions, come to consensus. And so there's really a balance between what we call distributed control, which gives this system a lot of robustness. You know, no individual is absolutely essential. And then also this ability for hierarchies to spontaneously emerge within groups. I had the opportunity to go to Mauritania. The desert locust that we were studying can invade up to 1/5 of the Earth's land surface during plague years. So what we find was sort of a rule set underlies these locusts. That told us, you know, that this alignment could lead to these huge devastating swarms where we just discovered by accident that the locusts were trying to eat each other. So when, you know, it looks like a cooperative swarm, but in actual fact it's a selfish sort of cannibalistic horde. Everyone is trying to eat everyone else and trying to avoid being eaten. The outcome is you run away from those coming towards you and you run towards those going away from you, and then this leads to these swarms moving across these desert environments. So we use a variety of technologies. Computer vision has been very important to us. So this is where we program a computer to sort of see the world for us. That's how I first got involved in this. And so we've modified this software over the years with the advent of Microsoft Kinect, which is a tool for the Xbox that allows you to interact with your video games. This gives you much more sort of a richer data set for looking at these types of behaviors. The reason this is important is we can now build better computational models and predictive models of where and when swarms may break out. And so that could be very helpful for control measures.